Hello friends, hi and welcome back to another episode of Insights with Nishirish. Today in Insights we are going to talk about professional skills. Some skills which are required to elevate your career to the next level. We have seen the soft skills and one skill from that is the public speaking skills. Yes, public speaking skills actually need to be groomed from the childhood itself. If the child becomes confident and is able to perform in public, no one can stop him from getting success and growing up in his career. But at times, people do not really concentrate on the skills and some actually ignore it. It happens with many people that when they go on stage, they actually freeze out of fear, anxiety. This is called as claustrophobia. Glossophobia is a fear, the fear of speech, the fear and the anxiety one feels when he has to face a lot of public or when he is on a stage and has maybe for any sort of performance. Now, why does this happen and how to overcome it is something we are going to see today. But before that, if you have not subscribed my channel, please go ahead and subscribe it because there are many more videos on professional skills, life skills, woman empowerment, parenting and much more which is coming on your way. So, getting back to the topic, public speaking skills. Public speaking skills are the skills that enable you to speak in public. Now, this is required in childhood when you are actually performing in different events. If you are a grown-up person, like you are in any corporate, then probably you may need the skills when you need to give various presentations or need to address your team as well. If you want to be a leader, if you want to have a promotion, if you want to address your team, and if you want to take your career to the next level, this is one of the skills one should have. Now, why does this happen that a person fails to have the skills? The first is the fear. The fear the person feels when he is on a stage. Fear comes due to lack of confidence, and lack of confidence comes due to lack of knowledge. It is very essential that whatever topic you have selected to talk, whatever topic you are going to talk, you need to have thorough knowledge about it. Yes, in such situation, it is very important that you know the topic very well. If it is something that someone else has scripted and you have just mugged it up and you're trying to deliver that, then probably that may be a failure. In that case, I would suggest that in any case of sort of presentation or if you're just going on a stage to address public or anything of similar sort, you need to make your own scripts. See that you use your own words with which you are comfortable pronouncing them as well as delivering them. So it is very essential that whatever you are going to say, you script it down on your own. You understand the topic, you make a script, you understand the script, and then you deliver the script. This helps you in such a way that if at all you forget whatever you have learned or whatever you have mugged up or whatever you have scripted, it doesn't hold you back because you know the topic and you can immediately, your flow, whatever you're talking, continues. So, this is my first suggestion is whatever you're going to speak in public, whatever script you're having, you should write it down and ensure you use your own words. You are comfortable with pronouncing them as well as delivering them. Second is confidence. Confidence comes when you have the thorough knowledge about the topic. So, whatever subject you are going to talk about, ensure that you have studied it very well. Refer books, refer people, talk to them, try to find out about the topics, get your figures clear, and then only be 100% sure about what you are going to deliver. Any point in your presentation or in your speech which you are not clear about, please do not speak about it. Because if you are not confident, your language, your body language or the words that you choose may reflect that you are not sure about it. So, second is the confidence that you should have in your speech, in your language, which will come only if you are thorough with the topic. Third is, whenever you are preparing any script for your speech or for your presentation, ensure that your script has the punctuations. Yes, punctuations play a very important role in public speaking. How? Because when we study the script, when we actually mug up the script, learn the script or prepare the script, the punctuation helps us to take a pause. Yes, if you just mug up, you continue saying the words back to back, saying the sentences back to back without any pause, probably there would be a place where you would get stuck up. And because of it, your expressions do not come out clear, your pronunciation does not come out clear, which is very essential to catch hold of people's mind when you are talking. Okay, so it is very essential that whatever script you have made, you have the essential punctuations in it which give you a pause to breathe. Next point is breathing. Breathing is a very excellent exercise one must do. Yes, breathing in and breathing out is the best exercise you can do, because when you breathe in, you take in the oxygen which actually relaxes your mind, your heartbeat, and it actually kills your anxiety. So breathe enough of oxygen. Do this for at least 5 to 10 minutes if you are really feeling very much scared about your performance. Ensure that when you are breathing, you think positive about what you are going to deliver. Yes, you need to know the impact of what you are going to talk about. And when you know the impact of what you are going to deliver, it becomes easy for you to deliver the stuff. Next is, whenever we are preparing for such public speaking events, we should be aware of who are our listeners. In corporates, you are aware of who is going to attend your presentation. But when it comes to public speaking, you need to know what type of class, what type of people with what mindset are going to hear you. Their age group is also essential. Like if you're delivering any speech to children, you need to maintain that body language, that pause and simplicity in your language, your words and your pronunciation for the children to understand. It is also important that if there are elders or corporate colleagues in your presentation, then you need to use the relevant words which are necessary for the presentation. Along with this, it is also important that you understand the impact of what you are going to say. Your impact will make you understand that what questions will be raised after you have your speech, or what would be the Q&A session, that is the question and answer sessions. Of course, this will give you an idea of what would be the questions and what should be the answers. So, when you're thinking about the public you're going to address, you also get an idea about the question and answers, and it becomes more easy for you to perform. Practice is very important when you're trying public speaking for the first time. Yes, if you are feeling this, if you're feeling scared, or if you have that anxiety that if you would be able to perform or not, one thing you can do is you can either make a video of your own self delivering the topic, or you can ask someone to sit and listen to you. This will help you understand your positives and negatives when you are delivering your speech. This will help you understand what should be your gesture, what should be your body language, and which words are to be chosen. This will also help you to get the questions from the listener, which will again add to the question and answer sessions. It will also help you to answer the questions, then reacting to it. So probably making someone sit and listen will help you out. Making a video of your own speech will also help you out to understand how you are going to deliver your speech. Next important thing is, many times people fear for public speaking due to some past experience. Yes, it may happen that somebody who has tried public speaking earlier and badly failed, or must have probably mocked by his friends or bullied by his friends somewhere, sometimes in school, it may give a bigger impact on the person's further performance. Yes, sometimes such incidences give a very big impact, which may lead to you being glossophobic. So, to overcome this, there is only one solution, and that is practicing. Do not worry about something that has happened in the past. If you take care of your confidence, of the knowledge about the topic you are going to study, on your body language, your gestures, your question and answer sessions, and preparing for the answers that you are going to give, no one can stop you from being a successful public speaker. Yes, you need to forget your past if at all something like this has happened, or ever if you have not tried this and this was the very first time you are doing it, then you need to work out on this. Practice is the only thing that can help you to be a good public speaker. And the last important is you need to keep practicing. Only participating once in a while, sometimes giving a presentation, or once in a while participating in some public speaking will not make you a public speaker. You need to participate at various levels, various groups, and interact with people in such a way that you increase your vocabulary, increase your words, get the words of similar meanings. You know the accurate words, which word can be used where, and gives you a better vocabulary when you're speaking. Practicing is the only thing that will help you groom your skills. So, friends, this is about public speaking. This is for the glossophobic people who think that public speaking is something out of the world. No, friends, if you try this and take care of the points that we have discussed today, it will definitely help you to be a good public speaker. I wish you all the best, and do let me know how did you find this video, if it helped you to be a good public speaker. Thank you very much.